My name's Carol Puskic. I'm the Senior School Engagement Program Coordinator for an Indigenous all-girls program called Woolagoora Welgamanulu at Geraldton Senior College. I've been the program coordinator here for 3 years. Our task today is to do an English as a second dialect assignment integrated with the Indigenous language teachers assignment on symbols in artwork. The program here, Wajarri Welgamanulu, is an Indigenous program that is culturally appropriate for the girls. And Miss Ma, the Indigenous language teacher, consults with the school and with other teachers as to what is the correct thing to do in certain situations.
Symbolism in Aboriginal storytelling and symbolism in Aboriginal painting. Symbolism is a sort of magic trick that allows you to tell the story in several languages at once. So we want to start today and unpack what symbolism is. So I want you to think of as many different things we can use that can be interpreted as symbols.
Okay girls, today we're going to read The Rabbits by John Marsden and Sean Tan. The rabbits came many grandparents ago. So the rabbits is a symbol for the white people. And back in the early 1900s, there was a rabbit plague. So the writer here is symbolising rabbits and white people as to be a plague and a virus upon the land. First, we didn't know what to think. They looked a bit like us. Can you see there, Meg?
Our old people warned us, be careful. They won't understand the right way. I'm going to give you some books to read so that you can make yourself familiar with the story, so that you can think of your own dreamtime story using symbols. Some of you might have stories that you've been told by grandparents. Today's your chance to draft your own story.
My name is Edie Ma. I'm the Wajarri teacher, Indigenous teacher at the Geraldton Senior College. The component that I'm doing with the actual art is teaching them the symbols that are the correct and appropriate for the region.
Okay, today girls, we want you to type up your stories. Make sure you have a heading. If you want to include a picture, include a picture. Some people are more ahead of others. Look at Megan's pretty rainbow over there, so it's lovely. You want to make sure that you write in paragraphs and complete sentences. Okay, because you've all edited your work. Typed up your dreamtime story. You're going to draft a drawing of it today, and then you're going to do a painting on canvas, and then you will do an oral presentation about your story, Aboriginal symbols that you've used, the colours, to your classmates, and they'll ask you questions and mark you as well. On the back of your task sheet or assignment sheet is the marking key. So we want to know that you've covered the subject very well, you know what you're writing about in the dreamtime story.
I'm Edie Ma, the Wajarri language teacher of the girls. And their task with Wajarri is they have to link their story in the language. So a lot of them meant to use their title as their the Wajarri language. And parts of the story has to be translated into the Wajarri language.
Okay, today girls, we're doing our oral presentations on your dreamtime stories. You're going to tell everybody the title of your story, what your story's about, did you use traditional colours, the symbols that you used, the title of your story in Wajarri, your local language.
My story is about how the rainbow got its colours. I didn't use traditional colours because I wanted to be colourful for the rainbow.
My name is Olivia. And the title of my story is How the Young Tea Got Fire. The title of my story in Wajarri is Thanu Yamaji Gala Nyua. The reason why I chose this story is because my mum told me the story and her uncle told her the story.